Beloved, we thank God for you joining us once again. You can tell my spirit is energized and excited because this word is your ticket out of your wilderness. This word is the answer you've been looking for to get things moving in your life, because this is how Jesus has arranged this kingdom. It is the kingdom of God, and this is how the power is released through seed sown in any area of your life. So what is your responsibility before I come back to the text? Whatever seed you want to sow, come on, beloved, get your ears to the ground to hear from God and make sure that He is the one telling you to sow that seed. And once you sow it, then go to sleep. Stop fretting. Stop worrying. Stop doubting. Stop stressing until God speaks to you. Amen and amen. That's a word in season for someone. You sow the seed, and now you're worried, you're stressed, you're wondering what happened. He says, once you sow the seed, go to sleep. Wake up. In other words, go on by your normal business and wait for that seed. Because he says, Jesus said, the seed will spring and grow. Hallelujah. The seed will spring and grow. Take it with you this morning before you go to work, or as you go to work. This seed will spring and grow in your life. I'm just going to stay there, even without going further in the text. The seed will spring. So many of you have sown seeds to television ministries in different areas. You've sown seeds and you're wondering what happened. Beloved, I've even seen preachers on TV telling you to sow another seed to cause the seed you already sowed to come alive. Come on, beloved. Once you have sown the seed God told you to sow, then rest in God. Believe that the seed will spring and grow up. Jesus said it. Let me read it to you. So is the kingdom of God, as if a man should cast seed into the ground and should sleep, see, and rise night and day, and the seed shall spring and grow up, he knoweth not how. That's even more exciting. The reason you are falling prey to sowing the second seed to cause the seed you sowed to come alive, beloved, is because you are in quandary how it will return. You are in quandary how it will happen. You are in quandary when it will happen. Come on, look at the natural, because the Lord says if you look at the natural, you'll understand the spiritual. Does a farmer plant bean seeds or corn seeds? And if that seed doesn't come up and dies, he sows another seed to make the one that died to come up? No, it doesn't happen that way. No, the seed he sowed comes up. And if that seed dies because of lack of water or irrigation or excessive heat and drought, he has to sow another seed that will come up by itself. He doesn't sow a new seed to cause the old seed to come up. The old seed dies and is dead. But thank God that the word of God is incorruptible, undefiled, faded not away, unconquerable. The word of God that liveth and abideth forever. The seed that never dies. Glory to God. The seed that never dies, that shall not return void. God said, if my word comes out of my mouth, it will never return void. It stays with me until it finds ground in my heart. And then it germinates and brings forth fruit. Glory to God. That is the word in season for many of you. A word of encouragement. A word of power. I pray that I decree in Jesus' name that many of you who don't watch this devotion will discover it on the web, so God can answer your question. So God can allay your fears. So God can minister to your heart and know and assure you, so you will know that he is still coming, that he is faithful, that this word, this seed of the word of God, this seed of the kingdom will never, never die in the soil. No, it will stay there Your heart may be messed up, the seed will wait for you. Your heart may be corrupted, the seed will wait for you. Your heart may be pregnant with doubt, the seed will wait for you. Until your heart is right and the seed activates again. Glory to God. I was sharing this at our church and I talked about a seed that was discovered that's 2,000 years old in China, and they sowed it and it came alive. Then the Israelis discovered one that was 3,000 years old. They carbon dated them and discovered how old they were, and the seed still came up. If a natural seed, supernaturally preserved for that length of time, can come alive when sown, beloved, the word of God must come alive when you sow it in the fertile soil of your heart. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from my rejection. I sought the Lord and he heard me and removed the stress of the circumstance from me. This poor man cried and the Lord heard him and delivered him of all his troubles. That's the word of God. Sow it in the soil of your heart. Rehash it every day. Stand on it. Meditate on it. Believe God for it. You will not remain the same. He is faithful, that promised. I invite you once again to come and join us this year. Let's make it the largest parade we've ever done. March the 31st, the day, March the 30th, that is, the day before Easter, Easter on the 31st. That day we will parade from Union City to downtown Atlanta. We believe this time we'll go around Atlanta and then we'll congregate at the Centennial Olympic Park for a great rally, beloved. And then the day before that, we'll be praying at the steps of the Capitol. Come and be a part. The prayer starts at 11 a.m. It was so powerful last year. We believe with time that pastors will humble themselves and join in, and church members will humble themselves and join in, that we will stand in the gap for our state and for our nation. God will hear us. We love you. We'll continue tomorrow. Pastor Chika. Bye-bye.
Waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.